Hello, everyone, and welcome to a new episode of
Jesse's the Tetris.
Tips and tricks.
Today we'll be dealing with pictures in our video edit. Pictures? I know, all is film. And in a perfect world, you would always have video footage as B-roll. But since Seattle lost the Supersonics and the Treaty of Tordesillas has once been signed, this is obviously not a perfect world. So a filmer might send you pictures as B-roll. Let's just make it as awesome as possible. And here are my tips on how to do so. One thing you never want to see is a static still frame without any movement. If you're watching a video and suddenly there's no movement whatsoever, the viewer's going to be like, wait, is it broken? Is it still loading? I still hear the audio. What's going on? I'm freaking out here. So whatever you do, we never want to see static still frames, okay? At the most basic level, you could zoom in and zoom out a little. Just a little movement is all it takes. And remember, zooming in, even if just a little bit, draws the attention of the viewer to the subject you're zooming into. And zooming out, on the other hand, will take away the attention from the subject and places it in a broader perspective. To make it easy on yourself when zooming into a certain object, first place the anchor point at that subject. Now you can scale and you don't have to adjust the position since it will zoom in and out to the anchor point. To add a little smoothness to the movement, give your keyframes some easing. Instead of just having a simple movement from A to B, easing out the first keyframe will give it a nice takeoff, while easing in the last keyframe will give it a smooth landing. Especially the ease in of the last keyframe is really important because it gives the impression that the movement has reached its destination. It can be a bit confusing whether to use an ease out or an ease in. Well, you start your movement with an ease out and you end it with an ease in. An easy way to remember, you come out of your mama and you go into the grave. To make things more interesting, you can also give your picture a bit of 3D movement. To do so, you go to the effects panel, video effects, perspective, and choose basic 3D. Now apply basic 3D to your picture. This is what swivel does. And this is what happens when you change the values in tilt. Play around with that, but don't overdo it. Stay subtle. Make sure you scale enough so the picture covers the entire video frame. And like with zooming, always end your movement with an ease in. So with some scaling, swivel, and tilt, you can easily make the pictures in your video edit look a bit more interesting in a matter of seconds. Can we do more advanced things with pictures? Absolutely. Do we have time for that in this episode? No, I'm up. Bye. So as you can see,
it's easy as 1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3, Oliver!